Howdy folks, and welcome back to Let's Play Eschalon Book 2. In today's episode, we are going to continue exploring the Sylphwood and try fighting what appears to be a Torax. And we are going to see how badly it kicks our butt. Yes, that is a Torax scout. Fireball. Okay, our fire bolts are... and I'm out of mana. I could throw fiery oil at it, but I don't think we need to. Okay. 47. Oh my god! Alright, so in fighting Torax, we are going to go in knowing that we aren't going to hit them often, and they aren't going to miss us. This should prove a learning experience. What do we got? Perception ring, hide in shadows ring, shield, and brigandine leggings. Are they better? No, mine are impervious and made of steel. Okay. Jeez, I think I'm gonna actually save again. And we're gonna try and camp and pray that random encounters don't include more of them. Because, yeah, if that's just a scout, I'd hate to see what one of their warriors looks like. Oh god. Rift Harpies. Alright, I don't know how tough these things are, but I do know... light the damn torch. I do know that they're like the best experience in the game. However, when you get a group of them this big, yeah, you die. Alright, so, note to self. We do not sleep in Sylphwood. So that means we are going to just continue on walking. Yes. The harpies are supposed to be what everybody farms to reach the level cap, which, from what I understand, is a very monotonous and tedious procedure. Which I hope to God I don't have to do. A few yards in front of you, the ground dot drops off into a deep rift. The terrain underfoot is actually a rocky shelf which hangs over the edge of a crevasse. You can hear the wind rush off the rift and out of the eastern valley. Okay, I'll give props. That's actually a pretty cool effect. Where are we going? South, around Copper Main Rift. Ugh. This just isn't going to be easy, I can tell already. Trigger potion. Ha ha. Less? Oh. If I could hit... How much XP are they with? 400. Okay, Yeah, we're saving. And, I'm going to have to try and sleep. Because we cannot afford another fight right now. They come for you in the night. I wonder how this game does the random encounter calculations. I wonder if it like rolls on a table at certain times, or if it's just like a constant thing, like, you know, every like tick of time while you're sleeping there's like a 0.05% chance or something of a random mauling by some horrible monster. I got that one. Okay, we know that if we get into melee they don't screech, so They're like the Goliath boarheads in that aspect. You want them near you. Which seems entirely counter to any common sense. But hey, if it works. Oh, and they can fly over crevasses. Okay, I don't like these harpies. They're mean and they scare me. Get just one of you? No, of course not. Quit your screaming, you And I know that I've said I'm against it, but I'm totally going to abuse saving before camping while we're out here. Because this is mean. And I'm going to brew a potion real quick here, too. Let's see, do I have anything else I want to do before? No. And since we made a potion, I'm going to save. That's right, folks. I save after brewing potions. Just so that if we get wasted, I don't have to do it again. I am totally out of my league. Oh, dang it. They're really not, like, too terrible if you're just, like, in melee with them. I mean, they hit for, like, 7 damage. But that screech, that is just mean. Okay, and we are going to save and sleep. Yes. I'd like to get to this next town simply so that I have a recall point and I can fast travel out and stock up on some stuff. I mean, these harpies could at least drop loot. But, no. I think what it is, with how we built the Vaughn up to this point, that, like, my main weapon skill is 23, which I think is good, because, I mean, I hit them 50% of the time. I'm happy with a 50% chance to hit, but, like, my armor skills are 5, so I'm sure that I'm suffering due to that. And yes, I saw that chest, and it's probably some horrible trap. Yeah, that's what I figured. Harpy's just waiting for you. Come on. Okay. I will take those javelins and the rest of the stuff. Haha, 1 point away from encumbered. Dang. Man, I would not mind finding that town. Save again. Save after looting. Save after moving. Run away! I don't care about you, stupid harpies. Leave me alone. Hope they can't fly over trees. They can't. At least they don't do that. Could be worse. Please let this be a path to the town. Please. And that's some horrible monster there. A wall. This appears to be the port village of Edon. This place is not the bustling port you imagined it might be. The buildings are overgrown with weeds and is deathly quiet. Well, I would assume that would be because the Torax invaded. Ha ha ha! That's what I was hoping for. Let's see, storeroom. This is the ported on storeroom. Normally this repository is filled to the ceiling with goods that are waiting to be distributed to the merchants throughout Mistfell. It is also normally guarded quite well against snooping persons such as yourself. However, Port Edon has become little more than a ghost town, and this storage room is now unused. Boo! I see a guy down here, though. I'm taking his torch. You there. You see a young man looking over navigation charts. He is not initially aware of your presence until he hears your footsteps nearby. Whoa! You startled me. It's been weeks since we had visitors to Edon. Welcome, what can I do for you? For you. My name is Ben. I'm the port master here in Edon. It's my job to manage the cargo ships that come and go from this port. As you can see, Edon isn't quite the bustling port that it used to be, and so I have little to do right now, but I try to stay busy. What can you tell me of the port? Edon is an important distribution point for goods heading to East Willow, Everdale, Ravensgate, and even as far north as Durnor. Cargo ships from the four corners of Eschalon come here to unload. It's also much faster than having to navigate the North Seas to reach Port Gudad. Well, perhaps I should say Edon was an important port. In the past several weeks, things have gone from bad to terrible. We've had all kinds of trouble with the Torax. Scouts have been spotted just east of here, and they are making their way up from the western Theramore and terrorizing our supply wagons. We've had to set up a barrier on the eastern road to prevent the Torax from taking this port. I was relying on the northern route to transport goods, but it's dangerous and it takes much longer to reach our customers. So now most suppliers are just going straight to Port Gudad and avoiding this mess altogether. All the dock workers who were here in Edon have left to work the ships in Gudad. I've seen Torax to the north as well. Well, it doesn't surprise me. The barrier we've erected will only slow them, not stop them completely. They will find other ways in. The Torax scouts are set out ahead of the main invasion to locate access points, and once they've found two or three useful points of entry, they'll roll over Mistfell like a tidal wave. I guess it is foolish that I should stay here in Edon, but this is my first assignment by the Mistfell Port Authority, and don't want to leave my post until they tell me to do so. I only wish that they would have sent security, but as long as the merchant suppliers are avoiding this port, the Commonwealth Guard will not bother defending it. They have their reasons, I suppose. You got anything worth purchasing? Yes! What will you buy? Okay, buy my scrolls. That counts for something. I want to buy my rings. Also counts for something. And what do you have? Stolen skin. That would probably be useful, but I don't think I could use it. Okay, we will buy lockpicks. Yes. Just buy bars of gold. Why would you do that? Healing potions. Okay. Holy Book of Rye. Elementary. Soldier's Guide to Heavy Armor. And that's probably all you will buy from me, isn't it? Yeah. Alrighty. And yes, I know that I can ask him about transport to Picaroon Isle. I wanted to save first, though. See what he has to say. I need to get to Picaroon Isle on a quest that may prevent the Torax from invading. Ben looks at you suspiciously. Picaroon, you say? Why would you ever want to go there? He appears to be pondering the idea for a minute or two, occasionally glancing out the window to a boat tied to the dock. He finally speaks. I'll tell you what, I'm not going to question your reason for wanting to go to Picaroon Isle. Maybe you really think you're some hero that can prevent the war from entering Mistfell, or more likely you're involved in some illegal activity that I don't want to know about. It's none of my business, really. But I have a cargo skiff docked out there that's not getting any use, and I know how to make it to Picaroon in a day. How about I take you there myself for 350 gold? Sounds fair. Great, I'll be happy to take you any time, but just know that I'm not waiting around Picaroon Isle to bring you back. If you need to return, you'll need to find someone else to help you. So with all that worked out, just let me know when you're ready to leave. Alright. Well, we are going on 15 minutes, so I am going to save, and I'll see you folks next time.